Hello guys, this is 2-4 Fresh. I'm making a YouTube video for you guys today on Bethesda Softworks' Elder Scrolls 3 Morrowind, one of the best games ever made in my opinion. It is a childhood favorite of mine. It's been a while since I played this. I'm playing this on the Open Morrowind engine, thanks to the team working on this engine. That's recreating it so it's bug-free and cross-compatible with multiple different types of operating systems. Right now I'm running 0.36.1, 0.37 should be out soon, and should have some of the bug fixes I reported. I'm going to go ahead and start a new file. Each event is preceded by prophecy, but without the hero there is no event. In the waning years of the third era of Tamriel, a prisoner born on a certain day to uncertain parents was set under guard without explanation to Morrowind, ignorant of the role he was to play in that nation's history. Oh, Azura. As an interesting note, I can actually read and write Daedric, but I still haven't figured out what all that says in the intro of Azura's cutscene. There's Jib. Who do I want to be this time? I already have Nerevar. Raj'ai Mayal. I'm sure they'll let me go, asshole. I'm not sure about you. I've never seen you again after this. I apologize for any bad audio or anything like that, guys. This is my first Let's Play video. I'm going to be Khajiit this time. As an interesting point for the release papers I'm about to do with the questionnaire, I think the top question's always strength, the middle question's always magic, and the bottom question's always a stealth skill. So if you based on how you choose those, it determines which class you are based on which particular major or minor skill it's questioning you on. I'm not going to do that though, that's lame. Be a skooma addict. I'll be not an addict because that's lame. It's kind of like the crackhead of Tamriel. I'll be a skooma chemist because there's a lot of money in that. I'm going to do agility and endurance, because endurance is one of the best things to max out very fast, as it ultimately controls how much total health you can have, and agility just controls your ability to hit. Although if I wanted to hit, I could also do agility and luck. Let's see. There's always a lot of thought in picking this shit. I definitely want alchemy. I'm gonna make that a minor though, because I'm pretty good at it. I just want the levels it can give me. Security is a good one. So is armor. Speechcraft's easy. Don't want axes, those are useless. Mercantile's a pain in the ass to train, but it's ultimately like one of the most useful things. You can break the game with this skill. Enchant's nice. I don't need this heavy armor. I need. What do I have? I need acrobatics. Where's it at? Proceeded, you mentioned that you are born under a certain sign, and what would that be? I've played this a lot in my life. This one's one of the most useful because it gives you 50 points right off the start. And that endurance is really useful too. This one's useful so you can get to places. That one's always been kind of useless to me. Kind of useless as well. Spell that you can only use once a day. Or a spell that's just normal spell. But the open once a day is kind of useful, but kind of pointless as well. You can get that as a spell. That one, I don't want a birthstone that's gonna hurt me. I mean, I have a reason not to use this if it's gonna damage me too. That one's useful, but I'll get to the point where I won't need to heal eventually, so I don't want that. If I was gonna be a mage, that one would be useful, but ultimately, I think I'm gonna go. The Lord. No, what was it? The Lady. That 25 point buff to endurance is just too useful. Some people steal this thing. I'm not sure if they fixed that in Open Morrowind. I try not to steal anything, so I'm actually gonna go ahead and do this. I can pair of shoes. 'Cause I'm a beast, what do I care? Although it does limit the number of enchantments I can wear, which kinda sucks. Let's see, I'll take some food. 'Cause they did just transfer me here and my cat's kinda hungry. Apparently it doesn't like meat though. I'm actually going to do something. You guys might not approve of it. I always do this because this area is actually what I make my house out of. This really isn't cheating so much as just saving myself time. If you guys look at it as cheating, let me know in the comments. I can re-en- well, actually, I guess I can't re-enable them, but I mean, I guess just if you feel like complaining about that, go for it. I only want his ring because those bottles are pretty much useless. First, let me take your identification papers. Thank you. Word of your arrival has reached me, or only reached me yesterday. I'm Celis Gravius, but my background is not important. I'm here to welcome you to Morrowind. Yes, you're in Morrowind. I don't know why you're here or why you're released from prison and shipped here, but your authorization comes directly from Uriel, Emperor Uriel Septim the Seventh himself. And I don't need to know any more than other than that. When you leave this office, you're a free man, but before you go, I have instructions on your duties, instructions from the Emperor, so pay careful attention. This package came with the news of your arrival. You are to take it to Caius Casadas in the town of Balmora, or Balamora, however you want to pronounce that. Go to the South Wall Corner Club and ask ask for Caius Casadas. They'll know where to find him. Serve him as you would the serve the Emperor himself. I also have a letter for you and a dispersal for your name, or dispersal for my name. So I get $87 and directions in a package. It's all I really care about this guy for. Number one thing, I need enough to get a mortar and pestle, or pestle and mortar. One thing I can do. Kind of sucks because it's my only means of healing, but I can go and give the guy his ring back. Which then increases my disposition permanently with this guy. Or at least until I lower his disposition. Let's see how much he wants for it now. 89. I'm gonna haggle. Well, now I have almost everything I need. I need to get a spear or a weapon. Preferably a spear, because it's one of my main ones. Or a halberd. I don't really. The halberd will last me longer, and it seems to have the same stats. 1 to 3, 1 to 3, 5 to 20. Yeah. It's about double the price, though. Same weight. I'll go for it, because it has almost double the condition that it can possibly, or its max condition. So I guess for the time being, I got my claws. There's some mud crab over here. This game is brutal as fuck when you first start. If you're offended by cussing, don't watch me. I'm probably gonna slip up and do it all the time. I swear I'm not trying to, but I don't particularly see any offense in it, so it doesn't really bother me. If it bothers you, I mean, just stop watching, I guess. I don't mean to be condescending about that. I just know myself too well to know that I'm going to cuss. It's just gonna happen. I'm out of fatigue, so I'm gonna let that recharge. Ow. Fucker. Fetcher. Nying. Ooh. He's starting to get me. Ow. So right now my Khajiit, would I name him again? Raj'ai Mayal. Raj'ai is currently trying to get just enough money so he can start up his business as a potion maker. Raj'ai is not a hero of legend. He is not from Morrowind. He didn't ask to be sent here. He doesn't care about the internal politics or the strife, like the political strife that exists within this foreign land. He just cares about making money and maybe healing people. He's not exactly a hardened warrior either, as you can clearly tell. But he's starting to get the hang of it. He has a natural buff because he has claws, I guess. Kind of like you'd expect in Skyrim. Tough little bastards. Finally done with that, and now I have an additional $2. Starting out in this foreign land is kind of rough on Raj'ai. He's gonna have to struggle to make him ends meet. See some mushrooms, some cappers. He wonders if he can make something out of them. Something that might make him some money. At this point, he has no food that he can possibly eat. He has no home aside from a bed in the consensus office. Or the census office. I don't know why I said consensus. Oh. That might be enough for him to get a spear. Especially if he uses that silver tongue of his with his mercantile. His merchanting. Get maybe a lower price. He's asking 40, but surely Ariel is a reasonable man. So Raj'ai goes back to the trade house here. See if he can't get himself a little bit of protection against the many wild animals that exist around the cities. Ooh, we got it. Raj'ai likes spears. They allow him to keep his enemies away from him. Because like I said, he's not exactly a hardened warrior. He speculates that the further he can keep his enemy away, the less likely he gets hurt. Made a potion, so he has an additional $11 on it to his name now. He might be able to make it to Balmora. Despite the fact that Morrowind's music loops indefinitely, it is music to Raj'ai's ears. He has not heard music in a really long time. He's been sitting in a, I assume, imperial prison for the past, I'd say, 10 years of his life. He decides to try one more time to make himself some sort of sustenance he can actually, and he fails. So it is still 1 p.m. and Raj'ai is getting pretty hungry. He decides to try one of the local mushrooms. It has no effect on him though, he is still just as hungry. He wonders if the census office might have anything that he can possibly eat. He finds an egg. Decides, oh, no one's eating it, and it is only $2. He got some food in his stomach. Out of desperation, he decides to take a little bit of food from the census office. He still refuses to steal anything too valuable, though. And he goes ahead and takes a quick nap. Raj'ai is still broke, but at least he managed to make a potion that he might be able to sell to get to his destination. I really like that wall not being here. Raj'ai did not like it and was happy that he got permission to tear it down from the census office. They didn't seem to like it either. They thought it was stupid. Raj'ai decides he's going to try his hand at this combat thing once more before he sets out. He doesn't really have any viable food for once he gets there, and he's really broke. But of course, the food he does manage to find is not palatable and does not really feed him well. At this point, he's hoping he can maybe sell some of this, get himself a nice tasty cat treat. In the distance, Raj'ai spots something that seems a little off. There's a guy laying down. Find some quama cuddle. He saw some in the store, the trade house, and figured, well, if someone's selling it, there has to be someone buying it. He gets his arms ready, but it's just a bug. It's blind, does not see him, nor cares about his presence. He finds what seems to be a tax collector. He leaves the man's clothes on. He figures, let the man have some dignity. It is almost night, so Raj'ai starts to head home. It's been a long journey. He is tired from fighting multiple creatures that lurk around the city. He sits down. Phocius is telling Raj'ai that he should not be here for some reason, but Raj'ai has more important things to discuss. Yes, I found 200 septums on his body. You did? How odd that he was murdered but not robbed. Your honesty is appreciated. I'll tell you what, I won't forget this, Raj'ai, my all. In fact, if you're looking for some money yourself, I'd like to see the murderer of Professus punished. Killing an emperor's tax collector is punishable by death. Find his murderer, bring him to justice, and the census and excise office will pay you 500 septums. Raj'ai is tired, so he decides this is a good point to take a nap. He takes his halberd off, takes his shirt off, goes for a cozy old nap on this bedroll. But he couldn't really sleep that long. He was bothered by the murderer within the city that he just got dropped off at. So he decides he's going to take matters into his own hands. He told the concise office, which has Imperial Guards sitting around, that there was a murder, and he just asked me to do it. It doesn't seem right. There's these guys patrolling the city, and they don't even care. So Raj'ai decides this is a good point to test himself, to prove himself to the Emperor who has released him, to at least do some good to atone for his previous sins as a skooma dealer. That Fetcher, you're damn right, I did him in. And a good thing, too. He was skimming a lot of the money he gave us, a load of the money from all of us honest people, overcharging us on our taxes to keep the difference for himself. He was always flaunting his money around, showing off his new clothes and jewels, so I killed the bastard and left his body out there to rot with all his ill-begotten gold still on him. Raj'ai notices something is fishy. He's taunting all of his new clothes and jewels, but he only had common clothes and no jewelry on him. Raj'ai also does not believe there is any reason to kill him for that, when the concise office would be more than happy to take care of things, although, based on how they just asked me to take care of things, they might not. He figured, this man is unarmed. There's no reason to get a sword out for this. Although, he is starting to notice that this guy is particularly good at fighting. As he starts to wear out more and more from the successive blows that are being landed on him. But this is a good opportunity for Raj'ai to have learned how to fight. Raj'ai takes a moment, steps outside, knowing this man is a coward and would not follow him. Raj'ai is starting to feel the pain of this fight. She's starting to understand the gravity of the situation. She is not skilled enough to take this man out. But yet she tries. Because she owes it to the Emperor to do so. She decides she's going to wait until morning and let her wounds heal a little bit. Same time, though, she does not like the fact that she is backing down from a fight. So she goes back at it. She grabs a candlestick, not to necessarily steal it, but because this area is really dark at night and she's gonna have to be able to see in order to get back to where she's gonna be, especially with her face all split up from this guy smacking her around. But it is all to the same end, it seems. She cannot stay on her feet against this skilled opponent. She gets a few blows in, but ultimately he's wearing her out until she falls, and then just cheap shots are on the ground. She understands this land is cruel. Seems not to care for her presence. Or the fact that she is here on behalf of the Empire. She's getting a little better at dodging. She's learned a little bit about how to fight, but she's still not good enough to take on this man. She decides to call it for right now. And she goes and heals her wounds. She's curious. She has all these ingredients. Can she make another potion? She might be able to get back at this guy a little bit later on, but for right now, she needs at least some way to eat. But she destroys her only option. She makes a little money. Still, she's getting awfully hungry. She tries to eat this scathe craw. She knows it's going to make her weak, but so she instead decides to eat one of these scrub jerkies. It doesn't really get her very far, though. It only satiates the hunger without providing her any sustenance. She knows that Errol is a relatively speaking, he's a pretty reasonable man, so she asks for 23 instead. Took a little bit of pressure, but she got it. She has a little bit of money now. She decides to let this milk drinker over here wait until the moons align, when she will be strong enough to defeat him. So she equips her spear and sets out to the city of Balmora. She has second thoughts, though. What if she can make it out here without having to do the Emperor's duties? She checks. She buys some ingredients, sees if there's anything that she can make, maybe to make some money. But she fails. She tries to go fishing. She figures she's a Khajiit. She is born and bred for this sort of thing. But she sees no fish. Just bare waters. She decides to pay homage to Processus of Tillis, the tax collector. She knows she is not really required to do so, but she gives him a mushroom. At least someone will visit his body, and she takes a break, only to be interrupted by a wild rat. Raj'ai realizes she might have been right to choose spears. It's easy to keep enemies away. It's quick, stabby motion. Its chops and its slashes all get a good range. Raj'ai thinks to herself that she's learned quite a bit in the past couple days. She's going to go ahead and take a break and to try to remember, try to reflect on everything she has learned. But instead, she wakes up to being attacked by a weird slug-like insect. She decides she learned a little bit from that encounter as well. Maybe now she'll be able to reflect fully. But there's another slug. She decides it's dark anyways. She might as well go back home. Oh, the closest thing she can call home in this alien world. It is really dark, so she has a hard time seeing. She went from being in a dingy prison cell, a dungeon, to being out in the bright world, and quickly her eyes got used to it. Raj'ai had a lot to learn from that experience. She's a little more resilient to taking damage now, after receiving so many wounds. She's starting to feel a little lucky. So after trying to make some potions, she decides she's gonna try to take on this dark elf murderer. She decides the only fair fight for this still is just feisty cuffs. She is ethical, if not honorable, for doing so. She feels as though all the training is starting to take an effect. She's not going down quite as often. But she does still go down, and there's not a lot she can do about it. She, at the very least, commends this man for his prowess in combat. She wonders whether or not she took out the tax collector, Processus, by himself, unarmed as well, just by beating the guy in the face. She happens to note he has very meaty forearms. Or she has really bony ones, in comparison. She decides she's feeling pretty awful after this fight. She's gonna go. So she heads back out. Spear in hand. This time to the city of Balmora. She hopes there might be a place for her to stay outside the city grounds. If not, she supposes she can handle her own if there are any wild animals attack her. She just really does not like that option. She also decides a larger city might give her a better selection of foods or chemicals, ingredients that she might be able to make her business off of. She's a hyper little cat. She is excited to be in this wide new city. And she searches around. There's a manor for a council, she assumes, one of the houses of Morrowind that she had heard about as a child. She had suckled from her mother's teat, as the great Khajiit do. She finds an alchemist shop. And notices that she carries some crab meat. This lady is less reasonable than Errol was. She was able to make some food, but she decides to try her luck and eat just some crab meat for now. Because she's going to need the money. And she just lost all the money that she just worked hard to find. So she goes back outside, hoping she can find some scraps. She is no thief, but no one seems to be laying claim to these, and the guard does not seem to mind her taking it. She does not need these goblets, though, or these bottles. She does take a cup for some water. And some paper. She finally manages to make another potion after blowing through probably 10 to 15 more ingredients. But she's in luck. This city has lots of things, small things, things that won't be missed. As she checks all the lost and found crates, she does manage to find a few useful things that she might manage to take. A couple of potions and some money that had been misplaced but no one had laid claim to. She finds the Guild of Mages and figures this might be an easier place for her to start. The other lady was unreasonable and was a shrewd businessman, or businesswoman. Raj'ai assumes the guild will be a little more reasonable when it comes to trading. And she does manage to find some cheap ingredients. She decides to take some salt rice. All her eggs and her meat, her crab meat. As well as the calcinator. It is a cheap calcinator, but at least allow her to remove some of the harsh calcium from the water. And she decides to get busy with trying to make some potions. She does manage to make a couple, but not enough for her to really say that she's living the dream. She sells those and the expensive potions she found in Lost and Found. And keeps her restore health for food. She notices she can talk them down about a dollar on the price if she haggles enough. She wonders if she can go down maybe any more, but it seems she can't. She doesn't want to offend the shopkeep either. Which she seems to be doing. So she gets enough to make quite a bit of potions. She figures This is a good start to her business. Start with something cheap. Costs her $2 to make a potion, and if she fails, which she certainly will, it's not as big of a deal to her. And she spends all afternoon just working on perfecting her trade, remembering how she used to work the mortar and pestle in her youth. She decides this is a good opportunity for her to get some sustenance, so she drinks one of her potions before selling the rest. She decides an even 200 should be reasonable. After a little bit of haggling, it seems she was correct. She also wonders how much it would cost her to start to get some of the other equipment she needs, such as the alembic or the retort. She decides she can afford their retort now, so she goes ahead and does that, and then talks the shopkeep down a few dollars in price. Things are too expensive these days in Morrowind. In learning how to do this, she's starting to learn a little bit more on how to talk people down. She's getting a little better at it, although it's still a struggle for her. She decides it's another good time to start making these potions. It's a lot of hard work negotiating all the eggs and all the crab meat. But she's starting to get really good at this. She decides after selling these, it's a good time to call it a night and see if she can't find a place to sleep. She decides to sell 30 of them. She feels $225 is a good price for the amount of time she put into getting all the ingredients. She also decides this is a good point to get that alembic, and she figures $185 sounds reasonable. She doesn't know a place where she can sleep, and she's really tired, so she's gonna fetch a ride back home, back to the census office in Balmore, in said Yanine. All right, guys. Well, it's been nice playing. I'm probably gonna continue to record after this uploads, and we'll just have to see how the adventures of Raj'ai, my all, turns out. I will say she has a very bright future ahead of her. She will start out small. She'll start out weak, the underdog, and slowly rise her way to the top. Although I still don't think she is the type to care about the politics of the great houses of Morrowind, as she herself is considered Inwa to the considered an outlander to the locals. She's gonna have to do an awful lot in order to get their attention, and she's not sure if she wants that life. All right, guys.